Welcome to episode six. I have a lot of stuff to cram into this episode, so I'm going to keep this really short. But it's going to be really fun, and yay! You're going to get to see some backstage stuff. So stay tuned. Okay, guys, we're running downstairs because Rick, our nighttime doorman, his cat is having a birthday.
Yeah!
And we are going to sing happy birthday to the cat. Because no cat is left behind here at First State Broadway.
Meow.
Meow.
It's got to be a meow meow talk because that's her native language.
Okay.
Okay.
Meow meow meow. Meow.
Yep.
Okay.
Now, is there a name? Is there a name?
24 years old.
So what's the name?
Kiska.
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 So that'll be the only other word than meow.
You can say meow meow. It doesn't matter. Meow 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 meow.
How excited are you for Kiska's birthday?
I'm very excited.
Have you been waiting on bated breath all day?
I'm glad it's Kiska.
Yeah.
And not Krysta.
Yeah, meow, 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 Kiska, meow, 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 meow.
She's going to love that. I'll make sure to give that to her. Okay, blogosphere, this is Jamie Englehart. She is my dresser, and she's the best. Just FYI. She does... Well, tell us about this show. It's a little bit different than other shows, right? Because we're on stage the whole time.
Yeah, actually, this show, it's mostly about pre-setting.
Yeah.
So it's getting everything ready for you guys in the dressing rooms, and then taking everything that is used at all during the show, putting it in a laundry basket and stashing it all over the stage. There's little cubbies underneath the sofas and the tables. Everything has to be folded in a specific way so it comes
yes.
out right.
I'm introducing you to Jamie because not only is she awesome, but she is going to steal the camera today.
Yeah.
Not really stealing it. She's borrowing it because I know where she's going with it. But we're going to do a Jamie's eye view of the show and take us backstage through the whole show.
Yep.
So next time you see us, we'll be getting ready for the show. Yay!
And here is the place's dance party.
Lovely. All right. And here we are at Places. Krysta should be coming out now.
Okay.
Oh my here God. She yeah. is.
So here we go. We're going to do a little dance.
We got to make sure she's got her tattoo, her bracelets, her purse.
My slippers.
Her
because
slippers
I can't
on.
Walk around in those heels.
Yes.
You'll see.
I'm right here.
Oh,
Blake.
Hi, baby. Blake just cut in front of me.
Yep.
For what?
To get checked. Now Liz checks my mic.
I didn't know you were
Lovely.
Filming.
Thank you.
Blake, cut in front of me. Then we come downstairs. Then we're here with Sarah.
Sarah.
Hi.
The hair department. She checks to make sure my hair is covering my mic. The mic is a big deal. We make sure it's quite covered. She gets in there.
Just
a little digging. Just a little digging. There we
okay.
go. Say hi.
What?
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 Aren't we? Don't we look pretty in blue?
We do. Blue is blue. Blue.
View is such a.
I'm blue.
We're so beautiful.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so this is our little pre-show circle.
Yay.
Where we get together, and we love each other.
You're giving away
Say
all
hello,
our secrets.
Darling.
I know.
Hey, where's Heather?
Hey, where's Heather?
I mean,
where,
darn.
Where is Heather?
Darn it,
Once people watch this video, they'll be as talented as all of us.
Yep.
Jeez. Oh, the show's starting. Okay. So now we walk over here. Blake is behind the curtain. Hey! Okay, everyone's getting ready. They're all in their places. We say hello. We say we love you. I give Sarah a little spank on the butt.
Oh.
And then we come over here. Arturo's calling the show today. There's Laura. And there's Jamie! Remember when we saw her on the other side of the stage? Somehow, she makes it over here before I do.
It's
crazy. So now I'm gonna give her back the camera. Alright.
And this is where I put my shoes on.
Whoop!
And that was Rick.
This is also where I decide if I should have gone to the bathroom again. Since it's 90 minutes.
And
no, I'm okay. I think I'm okay today. But we've timed it, we know how long
just don't
I have.
Think about waterfalls.
Just in case.
Fountains.
running water in any way.
90 minutes on stage with no bathroom break. So I pee about, how many times do you think I pee before the show?
17,000.
Yeah. Just in case. We are crazy. Okay, he's about to go on stage. Have fun.
Love you later.
Love you later. Mwah. There he goes. Oh my God, he's about to go be on Broadway. So I'm about to go on stage, and the next time you see me will be 90 minutes from now. And who knows what will have happened out there, but I'll let you know. Okay, bye.
All right, even though most of the costumes have to be preset on stage for the show, there's one change. It's about to come up, and we have to go into the trap to do it. Take a look at this little space. So I'm heading up there with a choir robe for Kate Lopez. So now we're up in that hole in the stage. Aaron goes down at the end going to the subway. This is the only way we can pass things off to the actors during the show. And here we are in the wardrobe room. Sarah again. This is Jessica, our fabulous wardrobe supervisor. And that's Tim over there, who is the male dresser for the show.
Hello.
The most important member of the wardrobe crew is, of course, right here. This is Truffles.
Say hi.
Official puppy of First Date the Musical. There we go. His most important job is eating all the extra hamburger at the end of the night. It gets left over from stage.
And now we are back up stage left at the end of the show. Krysta off stage. And there she
is. Hey guys.
Oh my God, it was good.
Yeah.
Good one.
Water.
Uh-huh. What do you think, Zach? They're being really loud out there. It's the subtle acting portion of the show.
Doing good. Right?
There's tractors everywhere.
That's how you do it. First day.
First day. Now I change my shoes because there's more stairs to be had.
Very important
upstairs.
Slippers.
I can take my very important scissors. Hey, Kate, how was your show?
So good.
What about you, Bryce?
It's pretty normal.
Pretty normal? See, we don't get to interact, so we have no idea how the show's going. So
yeah, we finally get to talk.
We finally get to talk to each other. I won't go up Kate's skirt, even though I'm sure you're secured. Oh, we'll go up Bryce's though. So this is where I run in and change my clothes and go to the bathroom and go home. Hope you enjoyed our backstage tour. Mwah!
Ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, everybody.
Hello.
I'm here with Mr. Bryce Ryness.
That's right.
And we're both going to be eating this time. Because that's what happens on the Sunday two-show day. Sometimes you just can't do it. So what are you eating?
Today I am going to have some short grain organic rice.
Mm-hmm.
And chicken soup from Westerly.
And I have a bunless turkey burger from Bear Burger. Okay? So, eat with us. Com123ET. There are two M's. I don't know.
Okay.
Asked you, since your character gives Aaron so much advice through the show, what's your personal advice to someone going on a first date?
Oh, wow. Well, the last first date that I went on was in, I want to say it was 2000. It was like November of the year 2000.
In the year 2000.
No,
was she
just
a quite lovely woman?
It was Meredith.
I know it was Meredith.
She's lovely.
His wife. Mm-hmm.
My advice to anyone that's going on a first date is listen more than you talk.
I like it. That's why he's been married for so long. Dana, or Dana, because there's two N's, BD, says, what's your best memory of playing Wolf in Hair? I thought you were brilliant.
Thank you.
That part of you is so far removed now. Your hair is not long anymore.
I know.
You're playing in a romantic comedy.
I know.
Couldn't be more different.
I got zingers.
Yeah.
My favorite part of playing Wolf, there was a really incredible experience that I had, which was we're doing the show, and then the show ends, and we have the dance party at the end. this 6 foot, 5 inch, shaved head guy comes up on stage, and he's wearing a shirt that says, like, Iraq Veterans Against the War. And we're dancing and, like, having a, like, yeah, having a moment. And then it, like, we're doing, like, the arm-in-arm thing of, like, let the sunshine, looking out over the audience. And then kind of, not out of nowhere, like, I could sense, like, his energy kind of building and mounting and building and mounting. And then he just fell apart in my arms and, like, and turned and, like, just was, like, you know, kind of shake weeping into my arms. And he said, I did hair in college, and then, you know, life went the way that it went, and I joined the Marines, and then I went to Afghanistan, and I did some pretty intense stuff in Afghanistan, and I'm, you know, I was, it was nice, it was like he was reminded of back a time in his life before he had done some pretty intense stuff. To see how that show affected that man was like, it was a wonder. I will never forget that.
We have a question from Chris A. Negron. Says, do your kids enjoy your job?
Yeah, I think they do. My son is 2, so he sort of doesn't quite understand what I do for a living.
He knows he can play on the set.
Yes.
This is Bryce's family. Are they not... Wait, there's all these lights.
We've got
Hold
a lot
on.
Of reflection.
There we go. Are they not the cutest thing you've ever seen? His daughter, Mercy, I want to look like Mercy when I grow up. She's the prettiest. And his son, Judah, is the coolest. And that's his beautiful wife, Meredith. There it is.
We have a question from Wes Tay-Tay. I don't know if you know this person.
Is that Wes Taylor?
He says, 1, does the size of your nose help you book more comedic work? And 2, yeah. What was it like working on the illustrious web series, It Could Be Worse?
Wes Tay-Tay. So insightful. I think that the size of my nose helps me take myself not seriously. So as intense as I get, I have found that...
Such a serious answer about your nose, too.
The more serious that I am about whatever it is that I'm, like, committing to as an objective, in a comedy, it registers even more just because I look so ridiculous. Like, I'm making all the faces and the poses and that. Uh-huh. But then there's, like, that's at the end of my face. And so what was it like working on
It Could Be Worse?
It Could Be Worse.
Wes Taylor's web series, which you should check out. Season 2 is coming up.
I was really honored, like, the whole time.
You had a very major recurring role.
I did.
A lot of us just had a couple lines.
I did. I was really honored that they asked me to be a part of it. And that it kept coming back, and, like, it was just so fun.
You play, like, a douchey actor. Like, that the epitome of douche actor.
Like, yeah, like, alpha male, straight man actor.
Yeah, super serious about his craft.
So serious. But it was
not
fun.
You shouldn't be serious about your craft.
And they were wonderfully playful on set, and, like, it was a great time.
All right, well, those are our questions we have for today.
Fantastic.
You feel good?
I feel good. I'm glad I got to tell that hair story.
Good.
Thank you. Was it Dana or...
I don't remember which one that was. I think it was a complicated one. Hold on. Now we're... Dana. Yes, Dana BD, he remembered. Or Dana.
Dana or Dana, whatever. Dana. Thanks for that question. It was
Thanks,
a really
guys.
Amazing experience, and glad I got to share that story.
And come and see First Date.
First Date.
He's very funny. It's a totally different thing.
I'm pretty serious about being funny.
We're all very serious about being funny. Okay, bye.
Hey guys, so that was it. That was our 6th episode. I hope you enjoyed our backstage tour and my interview with Bryce. I think next time I'm going to do a doubleheader interview because we're almost at the end. I need to get them all in. So tweet me your questions for Christopher Cusick, and I'm going to do all the swings together. There's 4 of them. Vicky Noon, Eric Ankrem, Kevin Kern, and Sydney Shepherd. So they'll be our guests, but we're going to do them separately. Well, I'm going to do the swings together and then Christopher separately. So tweet me your questions about them. And if you have any ideas or things you want to see, let me know. And I hope you guys are enjoying it. We're about to do our last show of the week again. And that's it. Have fun. Have a good week.